In the last video, we looked at the first few steps of the website design process. Defining the purpose or objective of our website, defining the target audience, doing a needs analysis to ascertain the information needs of our target audience, and creating a sitemap, which is also called the information architecture of a website. The next step in the website design process is creating a rough storyboard of our website. But before we get into that, let me show you two examples of websites that I have recently created so that you understand the website design process better and can relate how the process gets translated into a real live website. The first website is of our charity, Timeless Life Skills. The purpose of this version of the website is to be like an online brochure that provides an overview of the charity to our target audience. We wanted to explain to our audience why the life skills we are teaching students are important, what are these timeless life skills, and how are we teaching them through our workshops, clubs, and labs. We broadly defined our target audience as teachers, school administrators, parents, and students on the one hand, and potential donors, sponsors, and volunteers on the other. Then we broadly identified their needs as more information about our charity, an overview of the work we have done over the years, establish our credibility, encourage audience to get involved with the work we do, what is called a call to action, use the website to spread the word about Timeless Life Skills, connect with us on social media, and get in touch with us through email. We realized that our target audience is very busy, and hence we adopted a very visual approach. Lots of photos and images and very little text. Let's have a look at Timeless Life Skills website and see how we translated the defined audience needs into an elegant website. At the top is our logo and our tagline, Life Skills for Success and Joyful Living, that explains our charity's key objective. Then we have the menu button on the top right. This is called a hamburger menu, and this is becoming very popular now because it is a drop-down menu that displays elegantly on small interface devices like smartphones. We then have an image slider with six large images that are called hero images and a short description for each. As the user slides through the six photos and text, the user gets a good sense of what Timeless Life Skills is all about. Once we have explained the main objective of our charity, we highlight that we strive to make the students future-ready and life-ready. We then define the why of Timeless Life Skills. That is, why has it become imperative today to learn these life skills? We then explain what are the skills and dispositions that make the students future-ready and life-ready. Notice that we use a poster, that is a visual, to explain this. After that, we explain our approach and give a brief explanation about our charity. Using lots of photos, we give our audience a sense of the work we do. Then we get to the details of our work and describe the workshops we conduct and the life skills clubs and labs that we help schools start to enable students to learn life skills through hands-on, project-based learning. This is followed by links to all the content we have created on life skills. Links to our YouTube channel, Facebook page, blog, our publications, and our slideshare presentations. To establish credibility with the website audience, we then show testimonials from schools and organizations, and through pictures, capture how students feel about our work. We also give a sample of the media coverage we have received. After having taken the audience through a journey of why, what, and how of Timeless Life Skills and given them a sense of the work we do, we have a call to action where we encourage the audience to volunteer with us. We also use the website to help spread the word about Timeless Life Skills by requesting the audience to like us on their social media pages. Finally, we have a contact us section where we give our email and links to our own social media pages that the audience can use to stay in touch with us. Let me show you one more website. I recently designed this very simple single page website for a young entrepreneur, Anand Mehr, who lives in the Himalayan village Pyoda in Uttarakhand, India. This young person has recently started a homestay in his orchards and he gets booking queries mainly through word of mouth on WhatsApp and on his mobile phone. He wanted a simple website with a lot of visuals that show the experience of living at his homestay so that he could send the link to people interested in making a reservation and they could get a visual sense of what is on offer. So, the objective of the website was to convert a query into a booking by giving a visual sense of what staying in the homestay would be like. Homestay location, amenities, tariff, what all activities are possible around the homestay, and other information a potential customer would require before making a booking. Let's take a look at the homestay website. On this website, there is no header with a logo, etc. There is also no menu bar because right now there is just one page. The first large image, the hero image, shows the homestay with the tagline, "Your home in the Himalayas." The next image gives a sense of the breathtaking views of the Himalayas from the homestay, and the text explains the location. The third image shows how the homestay is nicely situated in the midst of orchards and a forest, and explains what all activities the guests can do around the homestay. The third photo establishes that the homestay provides an authentic experience of spending a few days in a village with a local family. Then we highlight that the homestay can be an absolute delight for young people. This is followed by four images that show how comfortable the two cottages at the homestay are and what all amenities are offered. We then provide the details of the tariff and what all is included. To establish credibility, we have highlighted media coverage and shared guest testimonials. Finally, there is a picture of the young entrepreneur Anand with his wife and son, and his phone number is given so that anyone interested in booking the homestay can get in touch. As Anand's homestay business grows, he can invest in creating a more elaborate website and perhaps even offer online bookings and payment. That is, make the website e-commerce enabled. But for now, a simple website serves his purpose. The first website you will design for your school could be a simple website like this one. Just one page that gives the audience a good sense of what your school is all about, the highlights of your school. Later, you can add more pages. But even for a simple one-page website, you will still have to follow the website design process. Define the purpose of your website, define your target audience, and do a needs analysis. To translate these needs into a design, you will then have to create a rough storyboard with the text and images you will be using on your website. In the next video, we will look at how to create such a storyboard.